Welcome, welcome, welcome back, Butterfly. You have tuned back into my channel, Angelisa Cogdell, this Butterfly Ambassadors, and we talk about Jesus, being a woman of God, beauty, and natural hair. So today, you guys have tuned in because you want some tips and some helpful just guides to getting your amazing wash and go for the spring and summer seasons. So I'm so glad you're here, guys. I have low porosity hair. I have 4A and I have 3C hair, but your porosity is more important, guys. But I'm so excited for just what God is doing in my life. Know this, sometimes you do have more than one porosity, like myself. I'll be transparent. I have low porosity hair when I first started being natural, but over time, there are some parts within my head y'all gonna see in the video that my hair also has high porosity. And I noticed that because of how my hair was reacting to products that worked months ago. But then over time, I noticed, this works differently than I remember a few months ago. I'd watch back a lot of my videos that you guys probably have seen already, and it just proved like, okay, Lord, my hair is changing. So you all make sure, first and foremost, to God, seek his face. Like, he has helped me like this entire journey, and just knowing like my porosity, knowing like what my hair likes, what it needs. Alpha, okay, you gonna do you, boo. Like, just letting your hair be. Just understanding like what your hair likes. I'm gonna be showing you guys different products so you can understand like strategies of how to best help your hair grow, maintain that health, maintain the length, remain still and patient. Patience is the most important part of this natural hair journey. So I'm so excited you guys are here. Don't forget to like, subscribe to this video, and I pray that these tips, these helpful visuals, these suggestions, the product comparisons, testing out to see, you know, the residue will be on your hair, there's a white cast or not, just understanding all these different techniques, I pray that this will help you so that you can get your wash and goes popping and have body and not be stiff and actually have ringlets and be defined and beautiful and last long. Praise the Lord, because the summer heat, it's not gonna be no joke. So, I'm excited to show you guys what works for me, and I pray that this helps you. Now, the products here may not work for your hair because of the porosity, but pray to God. Trust him. Like, he'll lead you. He'll never fail you. God is so amazing. There's so many products in the world, and they're still making more products to this day. So, just find what works for your hair. Like, seek God. He will lead you the right way. All right, let's go ahead and get started, guys. I'm so excited. Hey, butterflies. So, the first thing you need to do is pick out products that'll work for your hair type. If you have low porosity, I recommend the Jamaican Black Castor Oil, and then, of course, the Manuka Honey, followed with the leave-in conditioner. Now, in terms of utilizing this for your wash and go, I chose Mylo Organics to just show you, and I paired it with the Aussie Instant Freeze Gel instead of the Wetline Extreme to show you guys the difference. All right, guys, so the first part of getting your wash and go to look absolutely amazing is to deep condition your hair, girl. Like, you have to deep condition your hair. That is so important with the summer heat. It smells so good, you guys. Like, it's absolutely amazing. That's how it looks. Now, this particular deep condition that I chose is full of moisture, so that's key. Pick one that's gonna make sure your hair is nice and moisturized before you wash and go. Hey, butterflies. So yeah, I made sure that I left in for like 5 hours the deep conditioning, and then I rinsed it out. But now I'm doing the test to make sure that it doesn't leave a white residue on my hair. So you see, I paired that with a styler, and that left the white residue on my hands. But the other side was clear that you saw earlier with the 5 hours I was talking about earlier. That was actually me with the white peony leave-in with the Aussie. So that is the one that's going to win for today. Yay! So deconditioning is so important, ladies. Please, please, please decondition your hair. Please find a deconditioning that would make sure your hair is not like moisturized, nourished. Look at the curl pattern, and that's just from the deconditioner. I have no product on my hair. I rinsed out this, and look, like, wow, God is good. So you need a deconditioner that will thoroughly
moisturize your hair, honey, to prep your hair for the wash and go style. So I put my hair in four sections. You need warm water, especially for those that have low porosity. You need warm water. It just makes the cuticle stay moisturized and opens up, so that way any leave-in or conditioner that you're using, that may not necessarily be a leave-in, but any conditioner that you're using will be able to penetrate each strand thoroughly, meaning it smooths out, no tangles, you know, it evenly distributes with ease. So you want to make sure that you have a leave-in that will have slip. You need something that's going to be easy for you to detangle, easier for you to manage your hair, and that is the purpose of deconditioning your hair, so that your hair will be manageable and it will be easy for you to apply on the leave-in and work it into your style. So that's what I'm doing here, guys. I like to pump this out of the spray bottle onto my hands and just apply it onto my hair like so. Once I get it fully detangled with my fingers, then I use a wide tooth comb, as you see here, and I start from the ends. I work my way up to the root, but I don't like hammer the hair like too hard. I'm actually taking my time. I just sped up the video for you guys, so you won't be watching like 3 hours of a video. But I take my time with this part because I'm not really into combs or brushes. I don't even have a Denman brush yet. So I'm just really big on finger detangling because it really just helps me have a partial control of how my hair is, so that way I'm not ripping my hair out. You know what I mean? So that's why I take my rings off for only this purpose, because I just don't want any hair to be ripped out. Look at the length. The shrinkage is real, you guys. So as you guys can see here, like my hair and like my ends are like moisturized and just coated evenly. So make sure, girl, decondition your hair. Like, your hair will love you for this, especially with the heat, humidity. Like, girl, you need to make sure your hair has care. So like I said before, I use the wide tooth comb after I have finger detangled my hair thoroughly first. Any knots, get those out. Any single strand knots, get those out. So I get all that out first because I don't want to rip out anything with the comb. So yeah, make sure you get your ends, baby, your ends, guys. Your ends need TLC. They are the oldest part of your hair, boo, so make sure you give them some TLC. I believe next wash and go I'm going to be due for a trim because it is May. So I like to trim my hair every 4 to 5 months. It just depends on like how my hair is doing. I just trim my ends. I just dust them. I don't go to like get them done professionally. I will one day at a salon, but I'm just into just doing my hair right now with the Lord. So now I'm going to be going in with the Aussie gel. What I like to do with this gel, it's so thick and it's very sticky. I'll show you guys my first impressions video of this gel up above. But what I like to do is apply this to my entire section. So I like to thoroughly distribute this product all over the entire section, and then once I have it thoroughly coated, I'll subsection and, you know, finger rake the product through each subsection thoroughly. And then I also will apply the product with the praying hands method as well. So I like to do both of those. I like to finger rake it. Now hold up, I know you guys are probably thinking, wait a minute, Jaleesa, you said that this would pair good. Why do I see white? Girl, it's not going to dry white. That's why we did that test. So you're going to definitely see white as you're doing your hair. That's normal. But the reason why we do the test is so that we can understand it's not going to dry white. You see what I'm saying? So, yeah. So now you see my ringlets are forming. They're looking amazing. And now I'm subsectioning my hair in that same section, though. And I'm just gently distributing the hair with the finger raking still, as well as I'm going to incorporate the praying hands method. Just to make sure each strand, each piece of hair is getting all the love that it needs for this wash and go to be a success. So have your spray bottle handy, spray your water out on your hair as you go. And I can also see like how much hair has been taken out, like dead hair from the past style that I had. And it wasn't that much, praise God. So you see here, I'm applying more product I'm evenly distributing it to the hair, doing the pans method, and just letting my hair do its thing. And the curls are popping, they look amazing. So I apply a little bit more. Make sure you get your hair and get your roots, get your ends and your roots. That's very, very, very important. And if you need more water, grab more water, that's fine. Just keep going. Don't stop. Like, you got to keep going, guys. And I like to go to the back of my head and kind of just pull it downward. And this alleviates me from that middle, middle part. When you do like your four sections, you don't want the middle part. You want everything to be like nice and flowy. So I like to make sure like the back part is like evenly downward and not just like a weird middle part in the back of my head, That's like so weird. So I'm thoroughly going over the strands. Next side is the same back part, but just the other side. This side, the product weighs my hair down amazingly. Like, so much slip on this side, and it's just like the curls are just in love with this Aussie gel. So I recommend this gel to anyone that has low porosity because it really does a great job of moisturizing the hair and defining your curls, and it also does elongate them because I have crazy shrinkage, you guys. So for my hair to actually be like, I guess you call that my shoulder blade, I guess. That's pretty impressive because I get a lot of shrinkage and I don't mind shrinkage. But for my hair to be able to lay down on my shoulder, pretty impressive to me. Now, y'all see the difference in a few moments. This side and the other side. This side is super like weighed down and just nice, and like the 3C is popping on the side of my head. So I have 3C on this side of my head, I can just tell, and I have a little bit of high porosity just because I need a lot more water and I need a lot less product. Now this side, I need a lot more product and a lot less water. I know, but that's what I have to do. Just for the application process. My hair loves water, but I'm saying for the application process, I have to do it that way. So I hope that makes sense to you guys. But yeah, so now I'm bringing out the Wet Liner Shroom Gel because, guys, my front part is trifling. It is like Judas. It's just trifling. So I have to make sure that I apply something thorough that will tame this hair in the front. I don't apply the Wet Liner Shroom to the back of my head at all because it doesn't need it. Aussie is perfect for the back of my head. But the front section, honey, child, honey, honey. Okay, I'm trying to tell you, it's like Peter looking down. She's focused on Jesus, looking down, and then he drowned. She just focused on Jesus all the way across the water. Now, y'all see in the back, I applied a lot more of the Aussie gel and I saw a difference. So you do that as you go. Like, if you notice, like, maybe I just apply a little bit more. Do that. Gel won't hurt your hair, boo. Like, you're good. You already got deep conditioning your hair. You got water. You got leave-in. You good. You're not gonna hurt your hair with gel, guys. Like, so don't be afraid of gel. So I applied some more, and it looks so much better. Now, this section, honey, child, Jesus, be a fence. So we are going to bust out this Wet Liner Shroom Gel. Yes, ma'am. We're not playing no games around these parts, okay? This gel is just perfect for this front part. I just need it. Yes, I just do. Like, I have to work with this section, you guys. Everybody has that one section of the hair that's just stubborn, and this is mine. And it's okay. I still love my hair. It's cool. But this is the part that you want to pray a little bit harder for. This is my section. I'm just saying. So, as you see, the ringlets are popping quickly because I apply the wet line. Aussie, honey, I would have been, this video would have been 5 hours if I would have used the Aussie. But I have gorgeous ringlets with the Wet Liner Stream for this section. I can't use the Wet Liner Stream for the whole head with this leave-in because I would prefer like the curl and enhancing smoothie with the Wet Liner Stream Gel for my whole entire head. But for just this top section, the Mielle Organics is perfect because I just need something to just be lightweight, give me some moisture so I can apply this thick gel. But if I was in my whole head, honey, I would do the curl and enhancing smoothie, and I'll show y'all a video of that up above so y'all can see the difference. of how my hair acts better when it has a different kind of leave-in. I'm telling you, you're gonna learn your hair. You're gonna learn what your hair likes, learn what it doesn't like, and learn what to pair for the particular style you're going for. You just learn as you go, guys. It's all a process. Just patience, you guys. Be still and know that He is God. He has amazing plans for you. So like just take your time. Don't rush. Like this video is sped up, but you don't rush. Like take your time with your hair and you're gonna see your curls develop. Like you think you have no curls, but girl, you got some amazing hair. Like just take your time with it. Don't rush it. I know it's a wash and go, so you would think it would take you 5 minutes, but sugar, no. No. You have to take your time. Now, some people do theirs in the shower. I refrain from that because I rebuked bacne. I don't have time for no bacne in the name of Jesus. So I do not do my wash and goes when I take a shower. I just, no. I refuse. I just like the shower to take a shower. I don't like to do my hair in the shower. I prefer to do my hair in the sink. It's just better for me. But of course, do what God is leading you to do. But that just works for me. So I'm just applying some more gel, guys, because of course, y'all see my roots are frizzy, honey. So I apply more gel to my roots. I get the roots. I make sure I just press it in there. I do add a little bit more water. You just couldn't see it on the camera, but I do add some more water and I just make sure that I get the roots the best I can. It's not supposed to be perfect, like, because we're not done. Like, I still have to shake my hair, I still have to add more gel. Now, you see, I'm going back in with the Aussie. See, I'm not done. So, I apply the wet line to get it started with the curls, and now I'm applying the Aussie on top of it because I really want my roots to be saturated and I want them to be laid, honey. Laid. So that's what I'm doing here. So this section just needs more loving. So I just put the wet line cream first. You see the difference? Look at them curls pop. And I also go upward. That's a tip for you guys too. Make sure if you have like a section that's just stubborn, honey, was help me with volume because I'm not into picking my hair like too much because I don't want any frizz. Whew, praise the Lord, we got through with that section. I shake my hair too. That helps dry your hair, but also helps the flow of the curls. So not everything looks more uniformed, but yeah, make sure you do your praying hands method upward for more volume on the sides that are stubborn. That's helped me a lot. So thank you guys so much for just tuning in for this part. I know that was a long-winded video. Sorry about all the talking, but I just wanted to make sure you guys understood what I was doing because you can see something and you were like, wait a minute, why did she do that? And wait, why is she adding this gel and that gel and all this gel? Everybody got gel. But it's purposeful because now everything looks more uniformed and elongated. So praise the Lord. Shaking is your best friend. I shake my hair for like 15 minutes, so give it a try.
Butterflies, thanks so much for watching this video. I pray you all are blessed from the tips that I shared today about getting your wash and go perfected for the summer days. I hope you all are blessed and don't forget to like, subscribe. I'll see you on the next video. Jesus, you changed.